In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can back up your RetroPie SD card without even leaving your own Raspberry Pi. So a few things that you're going to need. One, you're going to need your RetroPie installation set up and running. Number two, you're going to need a keyboard connected to the Raspberry Pi. Number three, you're going to need something like a USB micro SD card reader, something like the Kingston SD card reader that I've shown off in previous videos. And number four, what you're going to need is an extra micro SD card so you can back up your existing RetroPie installation. One last thing before we get started, this procedure will work for other Raspberry Pi operating systems. You'll just have to try it out on your particular system. And make sure you let me know if it worked down in the comments below. So the first thing you're going to want to do is get into the command line. And to do that, you need to press F4 on a keyboard. Once you've done that, you'll need to type in the following. What this will do, this will download rpi-clone, and this is the heart behind this whole process. So once that's finished downloading, what we're going to need to do then is we're going to need to go into the rpi-clone directory, and to do that you'll type this in now. And now what we need to do is we need to copy the rpi-clone into the following folder. And to do that, just type in what's on the screen now. Now make sure you note that you do require sudo before typing this out. I made the mistake here, so you can see that I'm not perfect either. So the next step is we need to plug in our USB card reader and we need to figure out what the ID is for the newly inserted micro SD card. So to do that, type in the command on the screen right now. So I can see from my Kingston media reader, that the micro SD card is at the point SDD and there is a partition at SDD1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select SDD as the ID of the device that I want to create the backup to. So now we just type in sudo rpi-clone, the ID, which is SDD, and then -v to get the response back from rpi-clone so we can see where we're up to. So the first thing that rpi-clone will ask is whether or not we want to mount the USB device, and we need to say yes here and then press enter. And then the next question that it will ask is, do we want to initialize the destination disk? Now just make sure this is the correct one and then hit yes and then press enter. And this will take a little bit. This is just creating the boot partition of the micro SD card. And then it will ask you for the next partition if you want to give it a name. And in this case, it's saying that the old one was called RetroPie. So you can type that in here or you can just press enter. Now, please note, this whole process took about 10 minutes, but I've sped it up right now. So if you've got ROMs and so forth, which this installation didn't, then it's going to take a lot longer than 10 minutes. So be prepared to leave it for anywhere from half an hour to an hour, maybe even longer if you've got a 128 gigabyte card. So just be prepared for a very long wait. Go and do something else and then come back and check on it every 20 minutes or so. And once it's finished, it'll tell you to press enter to unmount the device. And once you do that, you'll be able to eject your micro SD card from the USB card reader. And you've successfully made your first backup of your RetroPie installation from your Raspberry Pi. Awesome! If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you subscribe. And if you already have, then make sure you hit that bell icon so you get notified of my new videos. And as always, imagine, learn, create.